Hello everyone, I'm Aaron Kendrick, and this is another developer update. I'm super excited to present this to you today, and by the end of it, I hope you will be excited about it too. This is the final update before we release later this year. Before we show you, keep in mind that a lot of what I will show you today does not represent the final look of the game, and some things will have simple developer textures. Let's take a look. Our networking programmer has been hard at work making the online system work again. You can now register an account and log in. All players playing the demo before release will get a special in-game house item when the game comes out. With this networking update comes the ability to see other players currently connected. You cannot interact with each other yet, but it's really fun to go through the game with a friend again. All the MMO features, such as the race game mode and the ambush game mode, will be fully functional on release. With this update comes a lot of changes. First, the main menu. We are going to add a changelog and events button, right under the language button. However, this is not implemented yet. On the bottom, we have all our links to our online groups. Next, the floor button. These small buttons can be placed on the ground and attached to a variable. Each room can now house any number of variables as well as global variables that exist outside the room itself. These variables can activate objects such as the extendable door. These doors can open in any direction and can be modified however you want. With this update comes day and night. While daytime gets a little brighter, nighttime gets really dark. Some things can create light to fight away the darkness. Speaking of, the torch is a placeable object that can be turned on or off. The default state could also be determined if it is night or day. You can even turn it on and off with water and fire elements. Water has also been added to the game. Occasionally, it will now rain, causing water pools to form on the ground. Other liquids also exist, such as acid, lava, sand, mud, slime. Floor tiles can be applied to any wall. Fire can now cover the floor in damaging fire tiles. Water will move fire when it walks over it. Similarly, ice can cover the ground in ice tiles. This allows ice to travel faster. Now on to a few player moves. Fires primarily move, now fires faster and creates an explosion on impact for splash damage and knockback. Shadow's teleport is now re-implemented, and it is now a lot clearer to tell where you will end up. Light now has 3 air jumps. That's all for this update. I hope you'll be looking forward to the first release of our game sometime later this year, and we thank you for your patience. I hope you enjoyed the final demo release. The Steam link is in the description below. Goodbye!